Well, it's been in the news. Greyhound racing has been shaken up by accusations of cruelty, and more people are asking what actually happens to the dogs when they're no longer wanted on the track. Well, sadly, thousands are put down, but one big-hearted couple is working pretty hard to rehome them as pets. Let's welcome Peter and Janet Flann from greyhoundrescue.com.au. Guys, who have you brought in with you this morning?
This is Rocky.
Rocky. And Rocky used to race?
Rocky's a young boy. He, well, he's a failed racer. He's only just turned 2 years old, so it means that at that age, you know, he wasn't fast enough to race, or whatever, and so he would have been one of those that was disposed of unless, you know, a rescue group takes him.
He's such a beautiful dog.
He's a big dog too.
What is it about greyhounds that make lovely pets? Because a lot of people would sort of look at them and think, oh, I don't know if I could have a greyhound as a pet.
Well, yes, a lot of people do think that.
Yeah.
So what makes him lovely, Janet?
Well, I really think that they've been through so much from when they were born, and
because a lot of people think that because of course they're greyhounds, they think, oh my god, I'll never have the time, I'll have to walk them 1,000 kilometres a day. But they're actually quite good homebodies, aren't they?
20 minute walk. Minutes, and that's all I ask.
They love to sleep as well around the house.
Is that greyhounds?
They take a couch.
Yeah, right.
Like
they've got so many positive qualities. I mean, they, you know, they don't have that doggy smell for a start. You know, they're very gentle and affectionate. They don't need much exercise.
And he loves being bathed.
And they don't bark much, I mean, you see. So there's so many good points about them. And,
What about when it comes to having greyhounds around kids? Because there have been concerns that because some of the failed greyhounds have been blooded, in that they've been involved in live baiting, that they've got that taste for blood. Does that then carry over to possibly leading to attacks in the home?
No, not at all. No. in fact, you know, whether they've raced or not raced, I don't think matters at all. You know, the quality is in the quality of the dog, and so when we home a greyhound, it's what we see in the quality of the greyhound at that time that makes it good for this home or that home. I mean, there's some greyhounds we wouldn't put into homes for children. Rocky would make an excellent.
He's bomb-proof.
An excellent.
He's so strong.
And of course, we've seen these just absolute horrendous revelations about the greyhound racing industry. Do you think it should be shut down?
Yes. Tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm quite serious. We see the bad side of it. Yeah. Absolutely. It's shocking.
It is a $1 billion industry. There have been suggestions that the industry perhaps could be cleaned up so jobs and livelihoods could be saved. Do you think that that is a possibility?
No.
Why not?
Well,
always when there's animals concerned, money will come in. It won't stop.
Well, let me just look at Rocky. I mean, can you justify putting 13,000 dogs like this to sleep every year?
Actually, the easiest way for them is they shoot them. As you know, they find these...
That's not very humane, the way they're disposed of. So if people wanted to get in contact with you, they can go to greyhoundrescue.com.au and perhaps foster a dog, see how it goes, and then maybe have a forever home for them.
We need lots of fosters.
Yep.
80.
You know, we've got a lot of greyhounds in kennels at the moment, but it's better for them to be in a foster home so they learn how to live in a home. We need lots of support in many ways. I mean, we don't get any official funding. We rely solely on donations and fundraising. So we, you know, and we've got big overheads. You know.
Well, good luck with it. It's a great cause.
Yeah, great cause. A gentle giant there, Rocky. Thanks for bringing him in. Peter and Janet Flann, thanks so much for coming in today to talk about greyhound dogs.